tonight to be here with Eric Worthman and Janice Gulkey.
Jessica Gulkey.
My great friend Jessica Gulkey. The co-writers, and Eric is the director of The Drummer. I saw this film about 6 months ago and was really moved by it. And when Myra said she was going to have it at the festival, I asked to do this Q&A. So first, tell me how you guys met.
We met about 30 years ago.
Oh.
We did a intensive at NYU over the summer, and Eric was one of, I think, the oldest person in the class. But we got along. He ended up helping me on a short film that I made, and contacted me about the first film, and we started writing together then. So.
And Jessica had a real talent for dialogue. And that was obvious in the first film and the little film I made there. So I asked her to help me out on my first film, which was already 10 years ago. But and so then I called her again when this film was in my mind and I knew what I wanted to do. So I called her to ask her to co-write it.
So tell us what the impetus was for The Drummer.
Well, I was approached in the first 2 years of the Iraq War by a lawyer named Todd Ensign, who this film is dedicated to, who had done a lot of work with Vietnamese soldiers, with Americans who had fought in Vietnam. And he had an NGO called Citizen Soldier. Mm. Iraq soldiers coming back from Iraq began to call him because, one, they wanted to get out, two, they had post-traumatic stress disorder, and there was other legal issues that they were confronting. He called me, I had been a psychotherapist for a long time, and he called me to do the psychological profiling about whether he thought the soldiers could take, in the Vietnam War, the government came after people who were AWOL. In the Iraq War, the government called the families and said, we are not coming after them. They have to report back to their unit, and if they're caught, tough. So Todd wanted to know if I thought the soldiers could withstand psychologically what would happen to them when they reported back to their unit. How would they handle, other soldiers might be furious at them, commanding officers might be furious at them, and then possibly they wouldn't. So I did that profiling. Todd was now working up in Watertown, New York, where he had started an anti-war coffee shop, which in the 1960s was a very powerful organizing tool. In this period, there were only about three or four of these shops. One was in Tacoma, one was in Fort Hood in Texas, one was in Watertown. And I went up to Watertown a lot and worked with the soldiers up there and worked with Todd. And in the middle of this, we had an idea of doing conferences on base towns with soldiers who were on the base towns and the clinicians who were in those towns. Mm-hmm. And that's when I began to get the idea for doing this film.
It's really desolate up there, and there's one of the things that's really moving about this film is how desolate and how lonely and isolated their lives are. Who knew we'd all be like that? Mm-hmm. But anyway, tell me how you got Danny Glover to do this.
I was at an environmental conference called Bioneers, which is the biggest environmental conference in the country, in San Rafael. It's every October. Danny was speaking on climate change and social justice, and it was kind of semi set up for me to meet him. I had to really approach him, but we were in the same room. And he was interested. He was very interested. I got him the screenplay. It took him 3 months to read it, and it was because there was a woman in his office. I called her and said, has he read it? She said, well, Eric, I don't know. I said, have you read it? She said, well, I haven't read it. So she read it. And then she called him. He was making a movie in New Orleans and said, look, this is you. This is the role.
Yeah, it's a really wonderful role.
One thing I want to say. The character I created and Jessica and I created for Danny is not anything like Todd Ensign. I did that on purpose. So people, this is not like Todd Ensign. He was a wonderful man, but this is a very different character we created.
Well, enjoy the film. Thank you all for coming out.
Thank you, Martha.
Yeah, thank you.